LPM student command element leader Dominga Dala said that a child leaving school with grade 11 might struggle to get into higher learning institutions as they require grade 12.
What is UNAM's requirement? It says that you should have grade 12 for you to be admitted at the institution of higher learning. So currently, I do not think that UNAM has changed their policies to integrate these students or learners that are going to finish schools at grade 11. So we are basically, what we are basically doing is let all the dumb kids go on the street and then we absorb the smart ones. So it's a disaster. And also they have such a low possibility for them to be admitted at institutions of higher learning abroad. Because South Africa as well as abroad, you need to have a grade 12 certificate. So if you have a grade 11 certificate, what is the guarantee that you will be admitted in the institutions of higher learning? So it's actually a disastrous move. For a learner, is accepted into the education system, they need to take a competency test. By that, we can determine what field of study are they going to take up until tertiary education. I think that will help because we have a situation where some learners are not good at academics or they are not good at science fault. Yes. But because of the under this education system, they are forced to do that and that results into lower performance of a learner. So we need to take competency test. From there, we are able to determine if you are going to do the science field or are you going to do sports.
LPM members present at the press conference added that the whole education system needs a revamp.
I know very well that having all your subjects, not most students, we even saw the pass rate of the higher level and the pass rate of the ordinary level. The students or the learners of the higher level did much better than the ordinary level. So, and also, it higher level modules or subjects kind of are the ones that give the points, more points to the learners to pass. So what are they going to do? We have to fix the whole education system, not just one thing and expect something else from this one thing. It's the whole education system that needs to be fixed. The teachers, the time that they give to the ordinary level students and the time that they give to the some teachers at most of the schools, I expect to give both ordinary level and higher level to the same class students. And thus, it results in the teachers giving more attention to the higher level students and leaving the ordinary level students, assuming that maybe it's ordinary level, so they are expected to do better.
But the challenge that we now face is that there is a excessively high amount of registration fees that students are required to pay, both at UNAM, NUST and IUM. Now the challenge is not that students don't want to pay it, is that they cannot afford to pay such a high amount and still be expected to pay full tuition fees before their second semester exam. Now the problem with that is already we have a useless institution like NASFAB who at this stage is not clear whether they will still fund registration fees for first years. So if with that already in the loop, will the students, even after they receive an acceptance letter from any university, be able to apply to NASFAF and then get that registration? I think there is one thing they must also make clear to us as per their recontracting process, that first of all, we don't understand and that we were never made to be a part of.
Deputy Education Minister recently announced that she was quite proud of the grade 12 part-time candidates performance for grade 12 in 2019.
In summary, ladies and gentlemen, the 2019 results of the part-time candidates once again could be described as more than satisfactory, and a similar trend is encouraged during these last 2 years, seeing that the NSSCO examinations that are based on the old curriculum will be phased out with the final part-time NSSCO examination schedules for 2021 academic year. This has been an issue that we've been dealing with all these days, and I hope it's understood.
The LPM is ready to engage the Education Ministry to find solutions to the learners' plea.